In this video, we will be discussing how and when to use the z-interval tool in Google Sheets. Let's begin. Okay, so it is a common confusion to confuse the t-interval and the z-interval. The t-interval is this first tool on the tab on the bottom. And if you click on the t-interval, notice that there's something that's changing. Right in here, you'll notice that something is changing. So I'll flip back to the z-interval and back to the t-interval. Notice that standard deviation is changing. Notice in one, the t-interval, we were given sample standard deviation, and z-interval, we're given population standard deviation. It actually tells you this on the very top. Population standard deviation is known for z-interval. T-interval, population standard deviation is unknown. So that is when you use a t-interval or a z-interval, depending on if population standard deviation is known or if it is not known. And if the population standard deviation is not known, that means we have to use the sample standard deviation. So if population standard deviation is unknown, we only have sample standard deviation. So that's what you should be focusing on when you're reading the problem involving finding a confidence interval for the population mean. So let's read this problem here. You measure 21 watermelons weights and find they have a mean weight of 45 ounces. Okay. Assume the population standard deviation. The population standard deviation is 10.6. So we're assuming the population standard deviation is the value. So we have population standard deviation. Is population standard deviation unknown? No. So we're not using t-interval. We're using z-interval. So for t-interval and z-interval, we are both measuring the confidence interval for the mean, the population mean, but you have to determine if we know population standard deviation or not. In this case, we do know population standard deviation, so we are doing z-interval. Okay, so we're on the right tab. Now let's see how we use this. Based on this, construct a 95% confidence interval for the true population mean watermelon weight. So we have a lot of information here. We have four different numbers, actually. Well, that's good because we have four different blanks here. Four orange cells. So notice that we fill in the orange cells. We don't change anything down here. This is automatically calculated for you. So you only fill in these orange cells. First, we want the sample mean. That is from the sample data. So you measure 21 watermelon weights. That is the sample size. 21 watermelons is how many we're measuring. So that's the sample size. We'll put that in. And from that sample, we find that we have a mean weight of 45 ounces. And it just says mean here, but you know it's sample mean because it's saying it's from the 21 watermelons. So that is the sample mean of 45 ounces. And we have, as mentioned before, the population standard deviation of 10.6. Lastly, we need the confidence level. The confidence level is found from the 95% confidence interval. So we want to find the 95% confidence interval. So that means the confidence level is the 95%. It comes from the 95%. Now what you want to enter here in this blank is the 95% converted to decimal form. So that would be 0.95. Now you have all the four entries. We have the critical value, the margin of error, the lower bound, and the upper bound. Now what do we want here? In this case, well, we want the confidence interval, but it's in a specific form. It's blank plus or minus blank. If you have blank plus or minus blank, that is the mean plus or minus the margin of error. So that's one way of expressing the confidence interval. So the mean is the sample mean, 45, plus or minus the margin of error of 4.5336. Now, what does this represent in terms of the confidence interval? So the confidence interval is mentioned down here, 40.466 and 49.5336, so forth. And so to find that lower bound, we could do the mean, the sample mean, minus the margin of error. That would be the lower bound. And then the upper bound is the sample mean plus the margin of error. So it's two different ways of expressing the confidence interval. So typically it is lower bound and upper bound. So that would be a parenthesis and then lower bound, comma, upper bound. But in this case, it's blank plus or minus blank. So it's mean plus or minus margin of error. So anyways, that is how you use the Z interval. And this is when you use a Z interval over a T interval.